Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari.
Alright.
We're going to, check out the fishing lodge. Just not far from here, from the arm in. And after that, I suppose we'll go to Cloakwood. This is the bridge that leads to Baldur's Gate City. We're not going there for quite a while, but this is closer to it. Only 4 hours. Mint says, careful, Sapphire. Boo tells me that the earth itself here holds great dangers, and he's not talking about worms. Alright, I wonder if more Ankhegs then. We fought them. So, we can fight them again.
Why me?
We have bandits. We got bandits.
Alright!
Quite a few. But bandits are easy prey. Although they want us to be prey. It is they who now become prey.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Collect those scalps. Get enough scalps to get a secret decoder ring.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Go for the eyes, fool! Go for the eyes! Rusk!
He went for the eye. He went for the eyes. He got a little choked up about it. Well, the end of the map is here, so let's just see what's over here. Oh, peoples. Sonner, Jebedo, and Telman. And chickens. Hail.
Keep your heads about you and we'll work it out. We just need a little help is all.
You do, huh? Sonner says, damn it, Jebedo. We can't go on like this forever. There is no way we can keep quotas up when we're afraid to come near the nets. Excuse me, who are you? Jebedo says, can't you see I've got troubles on my mind? Leave me and mine alone. Ease off there a second, Jebedo. They're rough looking, but maybe they can help us with the problem. Oh yeah, the problem. Sorry for my manner, but we're poor folk, not accustomed to trouble. It's hard times now. We can't but get a boat into the water before she's swamped by the rains. I understand that. It's raining now. Telman says, it's that bitch of Umberlee. She's the one. Umberlee. Sonner says, steady, Telman. What he means is, we're being harassed by a priest of the bitch queen Umberlee. We don't even know why, but whenever we attempt to fish, she turns the weather sour. Two of us were washed away just walking to the docks, but we cannot prove to the guard it was her. We'd be needing someone to strong-arm her into leaving us alone. We've not much money, but I'll gladly give you a magical weapon from my grandfather's adventuring days. It's a meager amount for your trouble, but it would be a great service to us. Will you help a group of poor fishermen? Branwyn says, Sea Wolf venerates Umberlee, Sapphire. She rules the waves and sea winds from her flooded lair of the abyss. She is worshipped out of fear, not adoration. Mariners throw gold and gems into the ocean when caught by the storm, in hopes to appease the bitch queen. Her followers are as violent as their patron. It will be a good battle, Sapphire, but if you ever plan to sail the seas, know that you can fight men, but could you fight the tall waves? Will they offer me a magical weapon? Who knows if this magical weapon will even be useful to us? It's really not worth my time, but with a little extra gold. Sonner says, maybe you don't hear so good. We're poor, remember? Telman says, another 20 gold. That's fair, isn't it? Perhaps I shall, after all. I knew we could depend on you to do what's right, Sana says. She hides out near a small shack to the north. Watch your backs and act quickly. She's tricky. Good luck, brave friends. I've agreed to aid the fishermen north of the Friendly Arm by getting rid of a priestess of Umberly. They claim she has harassed and killed a number of them. She lives just east of the bridge to Baldur's Gate. Yep. These guys have anything else to say? Back, I see. Have you done it? Have you killed the bitch? No, we haven't killed her yet. Well, come back when you have. You again? I don't suppose it's this. I wouldn't suppose it's this right here, but let's keep the possibility in mind, and let's check out what's in here. Layla. Got me on my knees. What? Oh, you are not him. What do you want inside my house? To take everything I can find. I had the impression I scared you quite heavily. Whom did you expect? Well, why shouldn't I tell you? Maybe you can even help me with this. Another quest. Would you be interested in earning something extra? Eliminate the monster lurking behind my house, and I will reward you. What kind of monster are we talking about? It's a zombie, I think. What would be my reward? I will give you 150 gold coins. Fair enough, I'll kill the monster for you. Excellent. You will find him, it, behind the house, hiding in the brushwood. With all your weapons, it should be easy for you to kill this thing. I'm thinking it'll be anything but, since she said that like that. In the fishing village, a woman is threatened by a monster lurking behind her house. She wants me to kill it.
All right.
Good on you if you save the day.
Alright. I'm not gonna go into her stuff with her standing there. Monster, huh?
Sure.
Zombie? Well, there's a lake behind her. Or some kind of body of water behind her house. Is it this thing? Oh, a zombie. We can talk to it? Let's get in position first.
What do you want?
Wait a moment. You were able to talk?
Dear Lila, sweet Lila.
A zombie in love? How sweet.
What? Sign the contract.
Sign what contract? What are you talking about?
Sign the contract.
Whatever that may mean. Now I am clueless. Nothing. Should we ask her more about this? Contract? Can't get anything else out of him.
Sure.
And? How is it now? You kept quiet about some of the details. The zombie mentioned a contract. Ah! The zombie mentions a contract, and you believe it? The thought is ridiculous. No. I want to know what contract you and the zombie concluded. But I swear I never made an agreement with an undead creature. What kind of contract would that be? I don't believe you. You have to tell me the truth if you expect me to help. I did not lie. I never made a contract with this thing behind my house. But with my husband I made one. Here is the contract he is talking about. See, it stipulates that I shall remain his faithful wife even after his death. I couldn't possibly know this man would pay a necromancer to call him back after he died. Really. Imogen says, the saying, death will not end my love for you, really gets a whole new meaning. I don't think I like this interpretation, though. Branwyn says, the wishes of this husband are understandable, but his means are sordid. Ugh, Imogen says, I cannot imagine him to be really happy. Can you, Sapphire? Gagain says, I like splud blashes on my weapons and armor to impress my enemies, but if I'd have to kill that thing, I'd probably wash to get rid of the smell. Sapphire, what are we doing here? Imogen says, Sapphire, you won't accept this contract, will you? Tell me you won't. Do you have any idea what I've been through lately? I loved him. I signed the contract because I was determined to stay faithful to him as long as I intended to live on his wealth, even after his death, but that is sick. One or two. I have the feeling killing him would be really, really evil, since when is it nice to get rid of a husband, Well, it states in the contract that I should not cause his death, but isn't he already dead? The lawful option, So, she needs to move out of this house. Or, I mean, that's what I'm... This is kind of not saying it, but implying that she should not stay in this house. Or accept him as her husband, either one. I found this interesting, though. You didn't understand what I was saying. Any law authority would interpret it in a way that would get us both in deep trouble if I do what you want me to. What do you mean? Alright, so I'm going for more money. It's not that I want more money. That I will not act against the contract, sorry as I am. It states clearly that you have to accept the zombie as your husband as long as you want to stay in this house. Do you know what this means? He came back through this door on the first night after they laid out his cold body at the temple. He looked better than he does now, but far too pale and strange to see him walking. I had to prepare him a bath, wash him, and I ran out screaming. The others drove him away, and now he lurks behind the house. No, if you don't help me to end this nightmare, I have to leave without a single gold coin, just as the contract dictates it. Without a single gold coin. That's true, she'll have no money. Why don't you just burn the contract? Ha! He placed copies with influential friends all over the country. My husband maintained numerous connections while he was alive. No, my only chance would be his final disappearance. You know what? Yeah, that's ridiculous. I'll strike him dead so you can stay in peace. Sorry.
All right.
I'm not going to leave her poor and destitute because she signed this contract and then he found a way around it. Any last words? I will kill you, monster.
Go for the eyes, boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!
That was easy. I wonder if he would get any kind of punishment from the law.
Why me?
Why not? Everything is done as you'd requested. I thank you. I thank you so much. Please, I am no evil person, but too much is too much. Maybe I won't even stay here. The house will decay if he can't grant it to others. Farewell. I killed the woman's undead husband. She should be able to live in peace now. Again, thank you for your help. All right. Now we can rob her blind. No, just leave.
Sure.
That was interesting. Alright, stand by. Alright, let's explore some more stuff. This was purplish before, now it's just blue. What's his name? Wilton.
Why me?
Stop a second there, young'un. Because I heard what you gone and done for old Brun.
Brun? Brun? Who's that? Leave me be. I got nothing for you. All right.
Sure.
It stopped raining? Mm-hmm. Yeah, see, now it's... I don't know. More chickens. Ajantis. Hail, Ajantis.
Halt! Be you friend or foe?
Until you tell us who you are, how should we know? I am Ajantis, Squire Paladin to Lord Helm. I have come down from the city of Waterdeep to fight against the brigands that make these roads unsafe to travel. What of you? We too want to put an end to the bandit raids. In that case, why do we not join forces against these contemptible lawbreakers? I don't want to get rid of anybody, so sorry, we don't have the need for another companion. Well then, I wish you safety in your travels, for the roads are very dangerous. Diner here says, this Squire Knight looks trustworthy. Why, he reminds me of my loyal Minsk. He will be a valuable addition to this group. We can't fit any of them. There's no room for another portrait. Just cover the little thingy there over there. Good luck on your travels. I cannot tarry for idle conversation. As a paladin, I must look after many tasks. If you wish to join me in my task, then just say the word. Otherwise, leave me be. Yeah, I'd take him on, but we don't have room. I don't want to get rid of anybody, at least right now. If something else turns up, I'll keep him in mind. Jantis at the fishing village, if he's here later. Who knows? See what's at the far eastern edge, if anything. Must uncover all the fog of war. There we go. I find it satisfying to do so. What is that? I hear something. I hear something icky. This way.
This group shows promise. Exceptional.
Exceptional. There's something weird over here. Where's the enemy? Oh. Okay, yep, I knew it. Attack!
What?
These things are a little dangerous. I also got a cow and... cow and chicken! Magic missiles! Attack! Okay, barely injured. Yeah, it's literally cow and chicken. Wait, what are we doing here? Minsk, I don't want you to be... I want you to use that. Another pair of magic missiles. Okay, we got an oncake shell again. And a silver necklace.
I don't want to talk.
It's back.
Thy Valkor's mighty blade.
I still wanted to get hit again. Got it. I got a lot of experience.
Full plate and packing coop. Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
All right, one more then.
Sure.
What is that? What is that thing? It looks like a piece of like leather armor, but I can't pick it up. Who knows? Probably just a rock, I guess. Let's hang out with the cows. You save them from the vile oncakes. Farmer Brun. Oh, that's what the guy was talking about. Oh, I hear more of them.
Camaraderie, adventure, and steel on steel. The stuff of legend, right, Boo?
And Mince can carry a lot. Here, take the other one. I'll get closer and then take the other one. Oh, he's totally encumbered.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
I didn't realize. I thought it was slowed. I wasn't paying attention. Slowed, unfortunately. We can get a pretty penny for them, though.
Sure.
So let's talk to Farmer Brun. What did the other guy say about Father Brun? It was something he said out loud. Fisherman. Let's head back. See what this guy says. Alright, I can't get any more. Pick up any more of those shields. I have a feeling sleep wouldn't work on them, so. Well, that was quick. Because Minsk wasn't helping the first time. Gold ring. Yeah. I just can't carry these. They're 100 pounds. I don't know if anyone could spare 100 pounds. No. No one can even... Most of us can't even carry 100 pounds. I know it's slightly ridiculous what I have going on there. The gym bag, yeah. Animal summoning. I'd say I'm saving it for a rainy day, but it's raining now, so... It's actually not the case then. Square space here, or spare space, whatever. Alright, let's head back and see what that guy said about Brunn. Kinda curious. He doesn't like Brunn, I'm not, or something we did to Brunn? What am I seeing now? Another. Wow, no match for Minsk and Boo. What was that first hit? It took missile damage. But then Minsk did a critical hit. Natural 20, 32 damage from Minsk. Sweet. But somehow averted another critical hit. Not sure how. One dead. Silver necklace. And these things carry jewelry and gold. I'm not sure how. Not sure about a lot of things right now. That's a damn it. Yeah, she's been...
Valkor's mighty blade. What is your command? Your life should be mine.
So, a bloodstone ring. So I've got, yeah, 14 bandit scalps. Can't imagine ripping the scalps, a hair off of other living beings.
Why
other,
me?
Other human beings.
Go pester someone else.
Even if they are bandits. Oh, splitting up. Never a good idea. Oh, what's this hole? Oh boy. Full of kegs, I'm sure. Yeah, I don't really have a burning desire to enter that gaping maw of a hole. So what's he say?
Why me?
Oh, he doesn't... Damn it. Alright. Let's go back to talk to Brunn. Maybe there's some kind of conflict between the two of them. I can't remember what he said, obviously, because I walked all the way back. I've explored a good amount of this. Some of it's taken up by this lake. Mostly we need to go down and deal with the Onkake situation. So let's talk to Farmer Brunn.
Please, will no one help me? Anyone? I've nowhere else to be turning.
Please, you're young and strapping. Can you lend a neighbor a hand? There's something going on in my farm, and I can't afford to hire help. I've nothing to offer you, save my gratitude. Tiny here says, indeed, we can spare a few hours to help thee, good farmer. Is it not so, Sapphire? Yes, be nice. You need look no further for aid. What can I do? Oh, by the great mother, thank you. My son Nathan and his friends went looking for our missing cattle. Then they just up and disappeared. Been gone for days now, and With all the bandits around, who knows what's happened? I don't know where they're heading, but I saw some sort of tracks to the west. Please find Nathan. I can't afford to keep the farm without my son. Here I thought he wanted help with the hole over there. Tiny here says, thou hadst done well in accepting this task, Sapphire. Oh, thank you. I was north of the Friendly Arm Inn when a farmer named Brun asked me to help his son Nathan. He is worried that bandits may have waylaid the boy. I shall start looking to the west of their farm, as Brun said he saw some strange tracks in that direction. West of the farm, though. That way? I don't know what could be in that direction. Guess we'd find out. Oh, is that marked? Ankeg's Nest. Oh, boy. Maybe we'll just explore the rest of this.
All right.
First. More Ankegs. Yeah, they seem to be easy to find. Here we go. They're spotted before they even come up out of the ground somehow. One dead, critical hit from Branwyn. Oh my god, what? 10 missile damage. Whoa.
Thy Valkor's mighty blade.
I shall assist as well. Turns its attention on Kagane now. A pearl. Wow.
A simple matter.
All right.
Pretty hefty. We hear that. That sounded rather ferocious. I'm trying to uncover as much of the fog of war as I can. Oh, that's... Yeah, I don't want to leave yet. Okay. So the fishing village is really just two houses. I might be hearing them down there. I don't think we're ready to go down there, at least not after a rest. I don't have much doubts we'll find more of these things. They fought, like, what, six of them? Well, that's the site of where we killed two of them. Who's that? Gerd? Hurdy-gurdy. Look ready for battle, Gerd.
Yeah?
You've come here to fight Ankegs? Well, listen up. It's mating season, so it's primarily females coming up to the surface, looking to put on a little extra weight. They're hungry, they're aggressive, and there are a lot of them. Now, the point of this exercise is not to exterminate them, but to keep their population to a manageable level. Remember, they aerate the soil and thereby improve crop yields by as much as 15%. Food is going to be scarce enough in the next few years, so keep that in mind when you're out there. No more than 4 Ankegs per party. After that, it's catch and release, alright? Catch and release? I don't think catch and release would work. They turn right around and kill you. Most of the activity starts about 50 yards to the east. Now move out, everyone. I'll keep an eye on things from here. What? I'm assisting the ranger, Gerd, in her attempt to manage the Ankeg population on the plains south of Baldur's Gate. From where I stand at her side, I can see them swarming, coming to the surface roughly 50 yards to our left. On Gerd's instruction, however, I'm not to exceed my quota of 4 kills. I think I've already exceeded my quota of 4 kills. To the east. Over there. Maybe that includes... That doesn't include the ones down there? She's leaving. Is she gonna end up fighting us as well? If we kill too many? Oh, there's some kind of pond over here. I can't go that way. Now I can't clear out this fog of war. Ah, got it. It's the simple things in life. Alright, we're going around and...
Alright.
Some of us went around and some of us tried to go through someplace they couldn't. Alright, let's catch up. Catch up. We're still... Okay, we're having some weird pathing issue here. Want to stay together. Stay together. There she is again. Exciting, here we go.